Some dude has to watch it.
Busted. This is part two. The next day at school, an announcement came over the loudspeaker. George Harold and Harold Hutchins, please report to the principal. Krupp's sound. Uh-oh, said Harold. I didn't like the sound of that. Don't worry, said George. They can't prove anything. I skipped another page because I didn't. Actually, we can skip these two pages just to make it fun. A black and white image appeared on the TV screen. Harry shot the liquid instruments. How do you like the pre-game show as Mr. Copperfield down the screen? You know what? We don't even listen to that. Chapter 7, A Little Black Man. Mr. Krupp sat in his back in his chair, chuckled to himself for a long time. Finally, George got the courage to "What are you going to do with the tape?" he said. "I thought you never asked me." "I thought this, you know." "No," cried George. "You can't do that. They'll kill us." "Yeah," begged Harold. "They'll kill us every day for the rest of our lives." Mr. Krupp laughed. "Please have mercy, Lord. We'll do anything, asked Mr. Krupp with delight. He reached into his desk and pulled out a list of demands. He tossed it along. "Long as you live, you'll follow these rules exactly."